Historically, Minnesotans have sent a lot more tax dollars to Washington than we've received back here in the form of federal aid. That's why times like this, when Uncle Sam is sending a huge chunk of cash in our direction, those are times that are worth noting.
But it's not just roads and bridges. It's ports all around the country, east and west coast, north and south.
A big gathering at MnDOT headquarters, including U.S. Reps Dean Phillips and Angie Craig, to celebrate the passage of the Infrastructure Investment and Jobs Act.
A pothole doesn't give a damn what your politics are. It just wants and needs to be fixed.
$4.5 billion will go to highways over the next 10 years, with other money going to public transit, water infrastructure, bridges, rail, wildlife protection, broadband, and cybersecurity.
The level of crashes in Minnesota is unacceptable. Across the country, it's unacceptable. And so we're going to look to places where we can make those investments more immediately.
Democrats Craig, Phillips, and Betty McCollum all voted for the infrastructure bill. All four Republicans and Democrat Ilhan Omar voted against it.
What I care about is the fact that we got it done and that future generations will be driving over these bridges.
With a politically divided legislature in Minnesota, we know we're not going to see a gas tax hike anytime soon in this state. That's one of the reasons why the people at MnDOT are very happy to see this federal money coming in. But at the same time, they caution that Minnesota will need to do a local match for part of this federal money. In St. Paul, John Croman, KARE 11 News.
As John just said, MnDOT will need to run these projects through the legislature to raise the matching funds needed to take advantage of this influx of federal money.